What's up, everybody? It's time for another episode of Benjamin David's Q&A show. Yay! Oh, do a little ha 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 for that. It's one more episode of my Q&A show. This makes two.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's life for me.
Funny, though, because when I thought about that after I read the question, I had so many movies just kind of into my head. Picked a few. A movie from last year that I absolutely love to pop in every time I'm feeling kind of blue or sad. Yeah. So I don't need to talk about that movie anymore, I'm sure. And then if I'm having a, like, if I want to be really nostalgic and go back to the way I used to feel when I was younger watching movies, a little kid, 5, 6 years old, I usually pop in the original King Kong. Yeah, I absolutely love this movie, so I always pop it in. I think I watch it at least twice a year, every year, since I've been 16. So, I wanted to save the best one for last. This is actually the film that I think I've seen more than any other. Period. I've only owned the DVD for about a year and a half now, but I've watched it over 100 times. And before that, I had it on VHS, and I used to watch it all the time when I was little too. I think I first saw it when I was 10, and that's George Leone's Western masterpiece, *The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly*. I think I can watch this, and it'll pick me up from any mood I'm in. I don't think it really matters. It's just one of those films that, for some reason, I never get bored watching it, which is odd considering it's almost 3.5 hours long. And I know a lot of people who have seen it, who don't share my enthusiasm for the film, talk about how long and tedious a movie it is, and they don't get it, but fuck those people. This is the greatest movie ever. A couple of names come to mind, and a couple of movies come to mind. I think, for me, the most obvious one would probably, I have two movies for you, both directed by somebody who shouldn't be directing a movie like that. Jack and Supernova. Francis Ford Coppola. What the hell, man? Dude made Godfather trilogy, Apocalypse Now, Rumblefish, many, many other great films, you know. And fucking Jack and Supernova. And I mean, I swear to God, those movies killed his fucking career, because I think he did a movie a couple years ago, or just last year, Tetris or something like that, which I wanted to see, but I don't think it ever even came out, or if it did, it was very, very limited release. But if anyone's seen that movie, let me know what you thought, because I saw the trailers and I actually thought, hey, this looks like, you know, classic Francis. I'd love to watch that movie. But that would be my first pick, because, like I said, dude, you know better. He gave me 7 examples, so I'm going to give him 7 examples right back. And these are just the first 7 villains that came into my head. And I'm just going to run down the list for time's sake. The first one that came in my head was the Wicked Witch of the West from The Wizard of Oz. I mean, that's obvious. Rick, or Enrico, from Little Caesar, played by Edward G. Robertson. Love that movie, and I always thought he's always my first person that pops in my head when I think original gangster. Cruella de Vil from 101 Dalmatians. She scared the piss out of me when I was a kid, what can I say? Hans Gruber from Die Hard. He's a good villain. Al Capone from The Untouchables, played by Robert De Niro, in a fat suit. And then Norman Stanfield from Leon, the bad cop from Leon, played by Gary Oldman. And then Mr. Smith from the original Matrix, the first Matrix film. So those are the 7 that popped in my. The first one, easily The Blind Side. I saw that movie and it's it wasn't Oscar worthy. It was okay, I suppose, for, you know, the intended audience, but yeah, The Blind Side, easily the most overrated movie from 2009. I know some people say Avatar, but Avatar delivered on everything that it said it was going to, so I'm not even going to go there. Anyways, and as far as the second one, that's easy too. Moon. And then there was Moon, and then Moon, of course, and then Moon, and then fucking Moon, and then what was it? Oh yeah, Moon. Yeah, Moon. You know, this is actually a tough question because my parents were fucking sadistic, and my mom used to watch Tales from the Crypt when I was a baby, so she would be feeding me with a bottle and watching Tales from the Crypts. So quite honestly, I've been watching fucking horror movies since the cradle. No bull. But the movie that actually, I gotta say, the first one I remember watching, I was like 5 or 6, and for some reason my mom thought it would be a good idea to watch Child's Play with me. Yeah. So we watched Child's Play, right? And Chucky truly scared the piss out of me when I was 5, and I think I had a kind of a fear of dolls anyways, like a lot of kids, because, you know, there's just something about dolls and that blank, ominous stare that they give you, and you know how sometimes gravity will make their little, their eyelids kind of go, yeah, that always freaked me out. You try and put them back up, and then, of course, they would close them again, you're like, no! but the thing about that movie was it was the first film that actually scared me enough to where my sister had a bunch of Cabbage Patch dolls, and I was so paranoid for, like, that one of those dolls would just come alive and kill my whole family. So what I did was, we had one of those old, growing up, kerosene heaters, you know, the kind that you just leave out and you try not to touch because you burn yourself really bad, and you had to put kerosene in it all the time and actually start it up that way. We were poor. Anyways, I grabbed a bunch of my sister's Cabbage Patch dolls, and I had a little kitchen knife, and I actually went through the effort of, like, burning the faces of all the dolls, because I figured if they were alive, they would jump out, obviously stop faking if their face was on fire. That was my 5-year-old logic, right? And I had the knife, and I was like, I'm going to save my family just to be on the safe side. So I think I burned like 2 or 3 of these dolls before my mom walked in wondering what the smell was, and she saw what I did, and of course yelled at me like you wouldn't believe. There was probably some capital punishment involved too. But yeah, Child's Play. As funny as that might seem, it was Child's Play. Chucky was the first, like, childhood horror for me. but yeah, that's the first one that just pops in my head. So, and like I said, I was 5 when I saw that, but then again, I was very little when I watched Gremlins and a bunch of other movies too. You know, another one that actually popped in my head was Ridley Scott's Alien. I saw that when I was like 8 or 9. I remember watching that movie, and of course, there's that classic, you know, chest bursting scene. And I remember for months after that, anytime I had any kind of chest pain or heartburn or something, I always had that kind of fear, like, oh my god, maybe something's gonna pop out. So yeah, I'd say that would be my number 2 choice, would be Ridley Scott's Alien. Jack Burton asked another question, but I'm saving that question for the next episode. I have an answer for it, Jack, I really do. And I gave you an answer, but in the interest of time, and just because I want to keep it to just minimum of 5 questions, I'm going to save that one for the next episode. Plus, for the answer I'm giving you, I need to download some videos and a few pictures, and I guarantee you it'll be worth the wait, Jack. And I decided that, you know, if enough people ask enough questions, I'll just, you know, do one of those kind of 5 questions this week, and then just whatever questions I didn't answer would just have to get put into the next show, I guess. Might be backlogged a bit if a ton of people ask questions, but hopefully I'll never become that successful.